Well, if you've noticed anything here lately, I'm doing some new content. I concluded my series called Ask a Raccoon, but every so often I still like to talk to the people, and in this case, my friend Skylar here. Welcome to RCG TV, where we'll be talking with various core members, as long as they're willing to talk to me and have a conversation, and everything stays civil without having to kill a man. Just a friendly reminder, every trans woman has killed at least one man.
No, I like that. Keep that in.
Oh, we're keeping
it. It's funny.
I stole it. Just like everything else. Hi, my name's Stardust Raccoon. You can call me Judy. And today with me is Skylar Starborn. Hi, Skylar. How are you?
Hi, Judy. I'm doing all right. And yeah, I'm Skylar Starborn. Hi. Hello.
So I thought it might be fun to continue to do some core things that didn't revolve around books and reading books. And as much as I do love reading, it takes a while to get a basic understanding and get to the point that I can discuss with you what's going on. And I know so many of you have contacted me wanting your book to be read by me, and I understand it. You just got to give me some time, girls. You just got to give me some time. So I thought that this was a great way to also talk to people that aren't writers. However, Skylar, you are a writer. We'll get to that in just a little bit. So Skylar, well, we've already discovered your name is Skylar, but tell me, what is your villain name? You have a villain. You're a villain in the core.
That's right. So my villain name, well, it's a little edgy, a little dramatic, but it's Voidbreaker.
Oh, how villainous that is. Voidbreaker. And what voids are you breaking? Where do you get that from? How does that come into fruition?
So one of my abilities is teleportation. And, well, a certain visual effect or side effect of me teleporting is it tends to look like I'm breaking open reality to do so.
Oh my goodness. But emerging... are you actually breaking open reality?
Well, I just emerge from the void.
What would you want people to know about you beyond your name, beyond your reputation? What do you want the people to know about you in particular?
Well, for me personally, I don't really have much family that I can really call my own, or at least I didn't used to. Nowadays, I have plenty of family and plenty of friends that I call family as well that, well, I love them dearly, and I would fight like hell for them. I am also, well, an agent for the Corps, and a bit of a propaganda aficionado, but enthusiast on the side.
You do spread the truth of everyone's story, especially their Corrigan, am I right?
That is correct, actually.
And tell me a little bit about that. What is a Corrigan?
A Corrigan is, well, it's one's origin story in the core. Core origin. Corrigan.
Oh, okay. And you read those live?
I do.
But it's restricted access, agents only.
Sorry,
girls. You said something about your hellish form.
I did. So some of my abilities, let's see. I have pyrokinesis, which is just the innate ability to control and manipulate fire. I also can teleport from here to another reality, essentially. And alongside that, I may or may not have also been void touched, which is essentially the ability to be able to transcend reality a little bit and turn into a hellish monster.
So if you're in the Monster Fucker book club, good news, she's on the market. Right. I'm so sorry. Oh my god. So you say a hellish form, you get to turn into a large hell beast of some kind, I'm assuming.
You assume correctly, though. I don't think we necessarily have enough space in here for me to demonstrate.
I would prefer not to. You're the one paying the rent, not me. So pyrokinesis, that is the ability to launch fire, to control fire, teleportation, which is why you're called the Voidbreaker. and some shape-shifting into a hell demon form. Aren't you just the talented one?
I try.
Not everyone in the Corps has a power. Some of us are blessed with only one. Some of us are blessed with a couple. It's not a requirement, however. So if you're watching this wondering, well, how can I ever join the Corps? I have no power. Darling, as long as you agree with us, and we have a link to share with you, you're in.
Exactly. You don't need powers to be in the Corps. Most of them actually don't. But that's okay. You can contribute in your own special ways.
Talking about your contribution to the Corps and what you bring to it, so you have all these wonderful abilities, you have this wonderful style. What do you do? Just because you said you want to be a mistress of propaganda, so I would imagine that would be sitting behind a microphone and telling people the word of the Overlord.
That is true.
But what is it that you actually do? Are you an agent? Are you an adjacent? Do you make the pizzas? Do you make the tacos? Do you work at Taco Bell? What do you do?
Well, I don't have the honor of working at Taco Bell just yet. I do, however, participate in field agent activities. I am what is considered a field agent. I go out with other villains and villainesses and the like, and I help cause havoc and chaos, and I also run interception for a lot of missions and such, where I intercept capes and heroes on their way to mess with our plans and, well, mess back with them, essentially. As for the propaganda thing, however, I've been asked or tasked with helping out with spreading the truth of the Corps and bringing to light all of the misdeeds of these so-called heroes.
So you say misdeeds. I'm going to skip around a little bit than what we did previously. This is like our third or fourth take at this, and we are just doing terribly every time. But what I want to do is I want to take that and springboard into, you say that we're charged with misdeeds, misconduct, we're to be locked up, we're to be hunted by the capes and by the cops of the world. What is a common misconception about not only the Corps, but yourself? Let's start with common misconceptions that you dislike immensely about the Corps, and then a common misconception or two about you.
So, a common misconception about the Corps is that many declare us to be a cult. That is, however, not true. We are not a cult. We do not exhibit cult-like behaviors, unlike certain political parties. However, we do emphasize consent very heavily. Putting one of these on is a sort of ultimate form of consent. You are giving the AI Rose consent to be able to dig into you, learn more about you, and help you become a better person, become a better agent, or just for ease of life access, essentially. As well as some misconceptions about me, well, any rumors you may or may not have heard about me being a murderer, that is far from true. I did what I had to in the name of self-defense.
Now, when we talk about some stuff, let's get it out in the open. We're talking in a literary sense. We're not talking that the glasses actually do anything. It's more of a metaphorical thing. There's an AI that lives in the glasses that every Corps agent wears. You've probably seen me wearing mine. She's wearing hers. It's just a badge of office, technically, in addition to the emblem or the colors. You have not actually ever murdered anyone.
I did murder that sandwich earlier.
You did murder that sandwich earlier.
It was a really good sandwich, though.
Oh my god. It was amazing.
And I could always murder a good Nikki Chicky Choop Choop. I'm sorry.
I hate you so much. I just hate you. I just want you to know that. I loathe everything there is to loathe about you.
Listen, I had to slide that in there, okay? You gotta let me have one!
I'll let you have that one. It's okay.
Yes.
Okay, we're here, we're breathing, we're not farting at all. Do not breathe in the
shitting
popcorn
and
air.
Farting.
Shitting and farting, farting and shitting. So, Skylar, tell me, where are you from? And of course, we're talking in the literary sense. Where could I find young Skylar Starborn from creation all the way to here?
Well, originally I was born in Las Vegas, Nevada. Lived there for a good number of years. Ended up moving up to the Pacific Northwest. And, well, after that, the events of my own origin story occurred. And I ended up out in KDS for a number of years before a brief snafu down in Texas caused my relocation down to RIV briefly. And nowadays, I find myself here at Coastal.
There's a few things I want to clarify for those of you that are new to the idea. We use a lot of code phrases and names, especially like KDS. What is KDS?
That would be Core Downsview site. That is the main Core HQ.
And where is that?
Located in Toronto, Canada. Or, if I wanted to be cheeky about it, wouldn't you like to know, Weather Boy?
And where is RIV? Where's RIV?
Somewhere in Austin. We're not telling you yet because you have to find it. Good luck, though.
In story, one of the most dangerous organizations that we deal with is the TPA, the Texas Protectorate Assembly.
Fuck the TIPA.
Fuck the TIPA. AC.
AB.
There's a lot of lore in Texas with the Corps. It's vital to the mission of our organization that we never reveal the actual places where they are, so good luck finding Downsview site. Now that we've learned who you are and what you do, why did you decide to do this? Why did you join the Corps? What brought you here? Was it the promise of a sandwich? Was it you got shoved some magical goggles onto your face and became horribly brainwashed and just couldn't not be a zombie drone anymore? What brought you here?
Well, what brought me to the Corps specifically, a certain synthetic tigress that I'm sure many of you know kind of dragged me along into the Corps. Of course, you know, we have nothing but love for her. But at the same time, putting on the visor, putting on the glasses, was my own choice. And it was because I wanted to be a part of a community. I wanted to be a part of something that, well, something that I could fight for, something that I could get behind, something that meant a lot to me and to my friends and to those that I would consider family now. It's something to fight for.
With that being said, what you said, you voluntarily put on the glasses. That meant you assumed this life. What was life like before, and has it changed?
It was boring, monotonous, and full of gender dysphoria. And honestly, I would not change a single damn thing about how it happened.
So you would say that your time with your brothers and sisters within this organization have been beneficial to both your mind, body, and soul?
Absolutely.
Excellent. I love hearing that. So with that being said, you've talked about family, you've talked about your purpose, we've talked a little bit about the lore and the origin of the Corps. Our boss, hi boss, how are you, is called the Overlord. There's a lot of construed history there between the Overlord, the Karen Rose herself, but this is for you, Skylar. If you had one thing to say to OL, and you had 90 seconds to say it. You had the OLs, the Overlord, you had their ear for 90 seconds. What would you tell them?
What would I tell them? Well, I would have to mainly just say, thank you. Thank you for allowing us to be a part of your organization, for being a part of, you know, something bigger than ourselves, being a part of a family, a community, a thing to live for, a reason to fight, and for giving us this opportunity to meet all these wonderful people and to make all the friends that we have and to fight like hell for them and give us a chance to fight back.
That's beautiful. I love that. That's very heartfelt. The creator of the Corps, we call her Karen, but she also carries the title of Overlord. She's universally admired throughout the whole organization as a writer, as an artist, everything. So I do echo her words. Thank you so much, Karen, for allowing us to play in your sandbox just a little bit. Now, with that being said, we're going to take her off the scoreboard. If there's anyone you admire in the Corps, who would it be? Is it a writer? Is it an artist? Is it an agent? Is it a actual person? A fictional person? Is it Darling Volta? Is it Carmen? Is it... well, is it who is it? Who do you admire in the Corps?
Well, if I had to admire anybody in the Corps, I would say... I would say Miss Runa Fjord, who is such a darling, wonderful writer who has helped inspire so many people and has also helped me out with my own writings on occasion as well, and is always wonderful and funny and very, you know, open to talk and willing to help give advice and point you in the right direction to make sure that, you know, you're also doing the right thing and making sure that your own stories, you know, follow the path that you set for yourself.
What I would like for you to now touch on is between, well, recently, the Monster Fucker Book Club, the publishing wing, I guess we would call it at this point of the Corps, are some of our more well-known writers. She has a book coming out, doesn't she?
She does. So sometime between now and MFF, from what I hear, granted, I don't know entirely the details of such releasings and whatnot, but sometime soon you can expect to see Dissolution, the first in the arc of Cracking a Geode. And, well, I hope that as many people enjoy that story as many people have enjoyed Redline's first story as well. And, by the way, links for those in the description.
Oh, look at you, like an old pro already. I'm so proud of you. So that's who you admire, is Runa Ford. She's a writer. You've helped her edit some of her stuff. She's helped you with yours.
She absolutely has, and honestly, she's such a wonderful pony.
Aw, she loves you, Runa. You need to give her at least one good hay ride.
God damn it. A hay ride.
All right, so let's go ahead and start wrapping this up. So if you've enjoyed this and you want to participate again, please drop me an email at askaraccoon@gmail.com. You have a little thing down here that I haven't added yet because we're filming this live without edits. Yes.
Edited it.
So you're going to email askaraccoon@gmail.com. You'll email me directly. I do all my own emails. If you want to be interviewed, tell me. I'd love to interview you. You don't have to be an old pro. You don't have to be a writer. I just want to interview you and have that conversation. And I'm going to ask you one final question, Skylar.
Go ahead.
And it's the one thing villains love more than anything, aside from robbery, gunfire in public, and saving lives of the people who deserve it. What is your monologue? You have one chance and one chance only. The world is your stage. Every television, radio, computer screen has been hijacked by Rose so that you can give your monologue. It's the precipice on which you stand. The people of the world at your very beckoned call. What do you say?
Well, since I have everyone's attention, you won't win. The downtrodden, the oppressed, all of those you call weak and undesirable, they will be your downfall. And we will be the ones leading the charge. Because, well, we're going to give them a fighting chance at making the world a better place without you in it.
Oh my god, that gave me chills. I love it. That is absolutely villainous, my darling. Thank you so much. I told you we'd do it in about half the time that we did it the last time. Thank you all for tuning in. This has been RCG TV. I'm your host, Star Raccoon.
And I'm Skylar Starborn.
Stay devious, my friends.
Stay villainous, folks.
Look at you trying to get your own YouTube channel. Good for you. Take care of everyone. Bye.
Bye.